Corneal blindness is a worldwide problem and can be treated by transplantation of donor human tissue or by implantation of artificial non-biological corneas. This cost action combines scientific, clinical, and industrial knowledge in the field of corneal regeneration. In regard of the aging population of Europe, such a focus is of great importance to help our increasing population of elderly individuals with corneal disease.
So this project is really a European success story. It started initially with three participating countries when it was started with Martin Jäger's group from Leiden in our European Cologne, and now we are 21 countries from all over Europe. So it's really a success story supporting research in Europe.
The importance of the cost is collaboration. We found out that there is something called the COST, a European action to bring people together. Professor Kersieven and I discussed this, and we decided to write an action plan. Several other people joined us to bring together people from Cornea, and that is what we have, a COST for Cornea collaboration.
And this COST action basically has two goals. One is to build a network of cornea specialists all over Europe to bring together European expertise. The second is to move research ahead, so to make progress in certain areas of corneal transplantation and ocular surface research.
The scientific exchange between the laboratories, which is very important, especially for young scientists to learn new methods and to establish a network of scientists who are interested in the field and on the improvement of their own skills.
In my research project in Cologne, I'm working with corneal transplant tolerance, and I'm looking at what the main risk factor for corneal transplantations, which is the presence of vessels in the cornea. I'm looking at how that affects the immune response against the graft. So I'm looking specifically at the interaction between vessels and immune cells.
In another project, we evaluate the suitability of limbal stem cells, which were derived from iPS cells. This project is in very close cooperation with a working group from Tampere, Finland, around Heli Skotman. And for this project, we had to change some of our experimental approaches. And to do so, it was very helpful to have the COST action, which helped us with short-term scientific missions.
I've been to two of the summer schools, one in Farna, the first one, or first one for me, and one in Linköping in Sweden. For me, it was really useful because it's so nice to actually gather with everyone in the field of cornea with different backgrounds, different PhD students. We got several lectures. We also got workshops in the field of the corneal cells.
I'm from the University of Antwerp in Belgium. Through this COST action, I've had the opportunity to participate in summer schools and two STSMs, or short-term scientific missions. What I really liked about these initiatives is that they are focused on the international mobility of young researchers and that all the related administration is really not too hard to complete. Through these international experiences, I had the chance to establish a network of contacts through the whole of Europe that were performing research in my niche domain, and it really accelerated my research as a starting PhD student back then. Also, the two STSMs I did, one to Professor Petrovsky in Hungary and the other to Professor Ferreira in Venice, really helped me to develop my research and social skills that are necessary to fulfill my PhD.
The COST action has been very beneficial for us. We have had chances to send PhD students to stays in labs in the UK, and I have another student that went to Cologne to learn more about imaging techniques. And a third PhD student joined last year's summer school in Linköping. All in all, it has been very useful for us to join the course project, and I hope we have also been able to contribute with something to other participants.
Because of the COST action, we had an exposure to many different centers all over Europe. And actually, that was extremely beneficial. And I must say that today, because of the COST action, we are able to transplant amniotic membrane with self-regenerating cells, which is an extreme advance for our patients. And as a clinician, I must say that the results are amazing.
The trial we are now running in Cologne is based on the BioCornea, which is a very small medical device for perforated corneas. And what we do is that we use fish scales to get a medical device. We decellularize them and decalcify them. And then if a patient comes in with a hole in the eye, we just put it on the eye to preserve the globe and to give the surgeon ample time to find a donor cornea to perform a transplantation.
The research focus of our group is on corneal disease, corneal imaging, and corneal regeneration. One of our main projects is in corneal regeneration, where we are developing new artificial corneas to replace the natural human cornea.
The COST action gathers researchers from multiple disciplines and induces fruitful collaboration. At the COST meetings, I was able to meet other researchers in the field of artificial cornea and improve my research. The meetings at the iBank of Venice and in Leiden were especially effective.
A great advantage of the summer schools was that people get to know each other. And one great advantage, if you have so many European countries working together, is that one can get material from others who are doing the same type of research. And if you know each other, it's much easier to send an email or call.
So our vision is that in a few years' time, blind patients can see again using a biocornea based on fish scale material. If this would happen, that would be a really transnational success story of this COST action.